Hello, it's Sarah. And tonight I want to do something called Decorative Painting 101. I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about what decorative painting is considered to be in my book. And that way you'll know what you're getting into. If you've never done it before, it's a wonderful hobby. And I loved it because I didn't have to think at all. These creative women, people, men and women, create the pattern for you. They tell you what colors to use, and then you just have to apply the techniques. And there are several different techniques that you use in this type of painting. You use acrylic paint, and it's wonderful. So I just wanted to, I have a couple examples here of one way you can get started with this. And there are several published artists out there. There's so many. I've been to convention, I've been to seminars, taken lots and lots of classes. And these people travel to seminars and they set up, they have a trade show as well where they can sell their books and they can sell other products that they like. This is called Mini Seasons. It's a book by Renee Mullins, and her company is called Plum Purdy Designs. And she created this, these patterns in here. These are her line drawings. She tells you what colors to use. And then you apply the techniques. So for me, I've always loved painting. I've loved art my whole life. And when I found this type of decorative painting, it was perfect because I didn't have to think. I didn't have to draw anything, decide anything. It was all here for me. And then I just applied the techniques that I learned. So what you'll find generally when you get a book is you'll have colored pictures, which are wonderful. So you can actually just, they've painted a sample for you, and then you can have reference that way. There's a line drawing of the pattern that you can then trace onto your piece and have her work as your guide. Or you can use parts of it or none of it and just use it as an example. This is, you know, it's up to you. I tend to, usually I'm drawn to the line drawings. If I like their drawings, then I gravitate towards their work. So then you'll also get, here's lots of colored pictures. And then here, so this one's called Ho 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 Santa Banner. And what you'll see here is the palette, which is the type of paints, and she uses the Deco Art Americana paints. And I generally use those and ceram coat. And these are old as heck, but it says Americana. And then it tells the color, light cinnamon. And this type of painting, you can be known as bottle babies, because obviously real painting, I've never taken a color wheel class because I'm too lazy and just liked being a bottle baby, but you can actually mix any color you want from, I think it's like 7 colors, I want to say. And that's how real painters paint. I mean, you know, with their palette, they have the 7 colors on there, and then you just mix and blend from those. And these companies, Americana and Ceram Coat, have mixed every color there is. So we spend a buck on a bottle and we have our colors, no mixing, but you can still mix. Anyway, it tells you what brushes you'll need. Usually, the source for the, what do I want to say? the canvas or whatever you're painting on, a lot of times they'll have a source where you can get that piece. Like say it's a, these happen to be banners, but like, all right, so here's a couple. Then you can also get a pattern packet. So they might just sell you a packet, one project. And I mean, they're usually around $7 or so for a pattern packet. And that'll come with a color picture, the list of paints you'll need, the brushes you'll need. This says additional supplies, so it just tells you everything you could possibly want or need. And let's see, then it has preparation, painting instructions, And then a nice color detail picture and a line drawing at the back. So that's the line drawing for him. These are, Renee happens to have on her website some free patterns, and that's why I thought that it might be nice for me to paint one of these. And if you guys want to, you can go to her website and you can download the PDFs and print them out for yourself and paint along with me. So this one I just saw today and I love it. It is called Winter Wonderland, and it's this cute snowman with a birdhouse and a little tree on his other arm and a bird, and it's just adorable, but it's a little bit bigger, which I liked. This is considered an 8-inch plate, I think. So, I mean, here's my ruler. Let's see, where's the numbers? So if an 8-inch plate, an 8-inch would go from here to here. I might have an 8-inch plate, but you could put this on the top of a round box. I might have a paper mache box that I could do it on. I think Michaels and AC Moore sell wooden plates or different surfaces that you could do it on. Or you might just want to do it on canvas. If you want to just play and see what it's like, you don't have to go get anything special. So I might play with that. But what I did was I did this one. This is called Winter Wonderland. And it's a little snowman. I did the snowman one. These are actually candlestick holders. They're heart-shaped candlestick holders. And I think she tells you where you can get them. I'm not sure. I know her website does. If you go to her, wooden candlestick holders can be purchased at her site. So she sells a lot of the surfaces as well if you wanted to get them. I just painted mine on one of my paper mache ornaments. So here it is. I think it turned out super cute. It's very country, and I think I'm going to do a tutorial for this. I'm going to do it on the circle. I mean, the heart's cute and I love it on the heart, but it's kind of hanging the wrong way. I love it. I put the this like pearl trim around the edge, and I put paper on the back and some glitter varnish. It's just, it hangs kind of, you know, it should be sitting this way because it's a candle holder. And so it's gonna hang sideways. So I figured I'd just do it on a round one. And I'll show you as well how you can, you know, use another surface. You don't have to use the surface that, you know, you can just make it your own. So what the first thing you do is trace the pattern onto tracing paper. This is tracing paper, so you can see through it. And you would arrange this on your piece, center it up where you want it, and then you need some graphite paper. And graphite paper comes in gray. I guess this is considered gray. You know what? I only have it in this sheet protector because I've had it for so long. And actually, an old piece is better than a new piece. Once it gets worn out, it's better. But it comes in this white color if you're painting on a dark surface. And it comes in a dark color. Obviously, I'm going to use that on this light surface. So that's the first step. You want to, I'll come back and start the tutorial from the beginning, but I just wanted to share. Oh, look, I also did this little Santa. Remember my Santa brushes? I did it on, and this is actually a metal box, but it was already base coated, so I just finished them since I had all my colors out. And I think it turned out super cute. So I'm kind of into painting right now. I'm enjoying it. I always have loved my Christmas stuff at Christmas time, painting Christmassy stuff. So it's always fun. The patterns are just so cute. So I just wanted to share that. That's a little bit about what decorative painting is. And I'll be back with the tutorial for this Winter Wonderland snowman. All right, thanks for watching.